The GSS is an incredible research tool, but like all surveys, it's important to understand its limitations. There are several types of survey error, four of which we will cover here. Coverage error happens when some members of the population are left out of the survey. For example, although the GSS targets adults living in the United States, people living in institutions like hospitals and military housing are not surveyed. Sampling error occurs when there are differences between the estimates from surveying a portion of the targeted population versus every unit in the population, like in a census. For example, in the year 2020, each GSS respondent represented about 70,000 residents in the United States. Nonresponse error happens when selected individuals choose not to participate, whether in person, on the phone, in writing, or online. Additionally, some GSS respondents are reluctant to answer personal or sensitive questions, which can reduce the accuracy of the representation in the data. Finally, measurement error is when there are differences in the estimates derived from a survey and the characteristics of the population because of inaccurate answers. This sometimes happens due to the mode of data collection, or other reasons like the wording of a question. Consider, for example, the question, "Are we spending too much, too little, or about the right amount on foreign aid?" When this is reworded as assistance to other countries, the results can change considerably. There are a number of ways to account for these errors to ensure the highest quality of research. We can use weighting to minimize the impact of sampling and non-response error. For measurement error, we can examine the mode of data collection and the phrasing of questions. And for coverage error, we can clearly define the population covered in the survey. It's important for researchers to be careful in the analysis and interpretation of GSS and other survey results, as these errors exist in all survey data to some degree.